What's up, keepers, and welcome back to another Friday episode of ARS Goalkeeping. I'm Alberto, and today we're going to take a look at how to deal with the 1v1 or the breakaway situation. The one-on-one is an extremely difficult situation. Most keepers have trouble deciding when to attack the ball or where to stop and set up for a shot. So we're going to talk about some of the tips that will help you prepare for these breakaway situations, and what to do when you have to come out, and some of the guidelines that might help you make those decisions on whether or not you leave your 6-yard box and attack the striker or pick a proper position and set up for the shot. The first thing any keeper coach will tell you in any one-on-one is to quickly cut down the space between you and the striker. Forcing the striker to make snap decisions is a keeper's best bet to forcing mistakes and easy saves. If the striker ends up passing the ball back, this is almost as good as a save because it gives your defenders time to get behind the ball and push the strikers out. But this doesn't mean to come flying out like a bat out of hell. Your best bet is to come out fast and low with your palms pointed outwards, just a few inches above the ground, and low enough with your legs that it would be difficult to pass the ball between your legs. If you come out with your body high up and your back straight, you will have several balls pass easily by you before you can even react. And for you keepers that love to run out and cut down the angle as fast as possible, you must always be ready for a quick shot when you're cutting down that angle. The best tip for this is to keep an eye on the striker's feet and watch when they're going to plant their foot for a kick. The moment you see a striker planting their feet and pulling their leg back or for the kick, the keeper must get into keeper ready position. This means that they must halt their movement, collect the feet into the right stance, and prepare for a shot in a split second. Staying vigilant and keeping an eye on the quick shot is a must when you are in breakaway situation. And if you find yourself stuck waiting for that shot, I found that giving myself a small bounce in my keeper ready position helped me keep physically and mentally alert for those close shots and the quick changes of play that happens in those one-on-one situations. It's important that you cut down the angle, but when it comes time to go for the ball, you must get as large as possible, making sure that the striker can't see any easy opening, and ultimately having them shoot the ball right at your frame or try to take a touch around you. Now that we know what to pay attention to for those quick snapshots, we have to focus on properly attacking the ball and to do it aggressively. Too often I see keepers going down on a one-on-one with hands and absolutely no power in their dive, almost like they're hoping to fall on a loose ball. The first thing I tell all my keepers is to power through their dive. Take the ball along for the ride and push through any legs that might try to kick the ball out of your hands. And I promise you, if you do this with full power, you will have a much lower possibility of injury. When you come out weak and scared is when you are at a highest risk for injury. To work over this fear of diving at the feet, there are several drills and games a keeper can work through that focuses on attacking the ball at a striker's foot. In these games, we are working on a full spectrum of the breakaway save, starting with proper stalking technique of staying big and low and watching for the moment that the ball is loose and attacking that loose ball regardless of the feet around the area. And finally, we're going to look at the moment when a striker decides to take on the keeper and it becomes a real one-on-one situation. I've recreated this moment with the drill in the video. The striker is going to have a hard service and then need to dribble through the square. The keeper's job is to push the ball out of bounds or to take it away from the striker. This is a learning ground for any goalkeeper. The first thing you will learn is to never hit the ground first, especially if the striker has control of the ball. Understanding the moment the ball is no longer under their control is essential, and keepers who can read that moment well will snatch up the ball faster than the striker can touch around them. To do this, you must make sure you're covering the ground as fast as possible and then standing up the striker once they face you with the ball. Lateral shuffling and stalking is essential to stopping any forward progress and either force them back or force them to make a mistake. If the striker does decide to take a step around the keeper with the ball, it comes down to a big dive moment where the striker has to put it far enough out of his reach that the keeper can get it, and that's the moment where us keepers strike. As I was saying before, the one-on-one is probably one of the most difficult situations out there. There are several variables in each game situation that might change the course of action for a goalkeeper and countless moments to doubt oneself. The only thing a keeper needs to worry about in these situations is making the save. It doesn't have to be clean or pretty. If a leg saves it, awesome. Just the same as if you save it with your nose. As long as you keep the net clean, you have done your job in this situation. Make sure to rewatch the video to catch all the different drills that I use, and to check back in soon for more training, reviews, and goalkeeper games. Let me know what you thought about the video in the comments, and if you have any of your own tips. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys again next week.